But I hope that the online marketing, that the only online marketing, will get screwed. I mean, I'm not. What's Schadenfroh in English? I mean, sorry, but Sony, with the PSP Go, I'm really happy that no one fights or buys that fucking abomination. A system that you can only support by buying stuff online, downloading it onto a memory card. That's the biggest bullshit system ever, in my opinion. Why should I buy the game online for the same price when I can get the game on a medium? Hello, why don't you eat it? There we go. I forgot the ginger? You serious? There was a ginger? Man, I'm talking. Yeah, I forgot him. Where was he again? Man, I'm talking so much with you guys, I'm not concentrated, to be honest. Oh, embarrassing. A thing? Behind the crocodile? No, sorry, the peer. Let's see. No. Huh? Where was he? Oh man, maybe here? Ah! There he is. Thank you. Yeah, the PSP Go. The Japanese people always buy stuff. If there's a new Nintendo DS in pink coming out, there will be 200,000 sold DSs and stuff. But I think in Japan, the PSP on the first week only got sold 10,000 times, and I hope Sony will screw the fucking system, cause no one wants this shit. Why should I say it again? Why should I buy a game? I don't own the game, okay? I own the game on a stick, but what happens if the stick gets destroyed or something like that? Okay, then Sony can say, hey, you buy it, you have an account, you can re-download it. Okay, but what's in 30 years? Will the servers be online 30 years or 40 years? No, they get shut down in 10 years or something like that. I think you know what I want to say. And you can't resell them on eBay and stuff. The biggest reason why they did this shit was that the people can't resell the games. And here in Germany, most of the big stores don't sell this shit. And it's good, because, like I said, PSP Go. Biggest bullshit ever. Here, the Xbox Live Marketplace. I really like buying stuff on the Xbox Live Marketplace. I'm willing to pay money for good games and stuff. But what's in 20 years? Like I said with the PSP, what is when in 10 years my Xbox breaks and I still want to play Shadow Complex or stuff? I don't know. I don't think that the Xbox Live Marketplace, that all the arcade games will be there online forever. you have them on a memory, but what is if your system, if your hardware crashes in 20 years, for example? Then you don't have the game anymore. You have spent hundreds of dollars for arcade games, and you're screwed. And I'm screwed because this will get interesting. Woo! Yeah, okay, but you're right, but you can't play this. Or maybe Microsoft brings in 20 years a collection on a 500 gigabyte disc with all released Xbox Live Arcade games and stuff. Yeah, of course. But you paid money for it. That's the thing. If I pay money for something, I want to have it for eternity. That's why I'm paying money for it, and that's why I have a big game collection with over thousands or 1,500 games. That's the biggest problem I see in download content and downloadable stuff. Or maybe when the Xbox 360 is maybe there is two new Xbox generations and you can save all the downloaded games on another medium and stuff. Maybe they don't know what's in the future. But like I said, I really like downloadable content, especially such games like Banjo-Kazooie, Shadow Complex, or really great add-ons that I still have to play, Ballad of Gay Tony and Lost and the Damned, but I will get these both on the disc. I mean, if I have the opportunity to buy the stuff on disc, I'm gonna buy it on disc. But I have to pay monthly internet and monthly electricity to live. I don't need games to live. You cannot compare this. Okay, I could go on a mountain on a wooden hood and live like someone 50 years ago, but no, I would buy. No, if you, no. Yeah, I mean that's the thing about it. I mean, why do games get sold online, and that's much cheaper for the game developers, for the publishers. If a game is sold online, they don't have to ship them, they don't have to package them. Why don't they do the games $10 or $5 cheaper? No, they have the exact price in Germany. I don't know how it is in US and stuff. I don't know. Yeah, they're greedy, that's it. And like I said, there will be so much good DLC coming in the future, but I think we will get more stupid DLC too. Like you can get an armor in Elder Scrolls Oblivion for $5. Was it a horse armor? I think horse armor. But like I said, I really support DLC. I think I have paid. I mean, I can show you my Xbox Live game list. I think I have 20 Xbox Arcade games on my Xbox. I mean, I paid 300 euros for online content because I like it. I really support the good things. And I really like the Xbox Live Marketplace and stuff that smaller developers or indie developers can do. I mean, look at Braid. I mean, no publisher would have released Braid. But Braid was such a cool game. And because of the online selling, they got the opportunity to sell it. It's 7 a.m. here? Yeah, good night. So I think I'm gonna make one world, then I'm gonna switch to Jack and Dexter. And after Jack and Dexter, I'm having my 2+ hours break. Adventures of Lolo? It says something to me, but... Yeah, they're always really hard, but you have to understand that I'm not always in the mood to play hard games. I'm gonna continue checking Dexter after this world here. I played it through 55% 3 days ago, I think. I mean, I think I don't watch the other broadcasts, but I don't think there's another broadcaster that plays so often so hard games like me. I mean, what have I played this week? 2 fucking hard Mega Man hacks. Then, yeah, okay, this Kaizo thing from yesterday. I mean, I need some relaxing time too. I don't want to play. And I want to play Untitled Story again on Masterful. The hardest or the second hardest difficulty. Then there is this one-hit-kill difficulty coming. And tomorrow, we're gonna celebrate our 1 month celebration thing. You're the only person who can... I think I quit it 2 times. I quit it on New Super Mario Brothers. Rage quit it. I mean, I played Super Mario Bros. Through 5 times. New Super Mario Bros. 5 times or more. And then I rage quit it. I mean, come on. Rage quitting on New Super Mario Bros. I really rage quit. I think this was really the only time when I really rage quitted like a badass. Where is that? I think Benji wrote me a message. Benji wrote me a message on the messenger thing and said, "Wow, I never saw you reacting like that."